I'm going to tell about welding processes. There are so many types of welding processes which we are using in our daily life. And there is some brief history of behind that. And late 19th century, scientists and engineers apply advantage in electricity to heat and or joint metal. In early 20th century, prior to WWI, welding was not trusted as a method to join two metal due to crack issues. In 1930s and 1940s, industrial welding gains acceptance and is used extensively in the war effort to build tanks, aircraft, ships, etc. Modern welding, the nuclear space age, helped bring welding from an art to a science. So this is the brief history of the welding and the types of welding. There are so many types of weldings, like fusion welding, pressure welding. Further, there are so many types. In fusion welding, there are two types: homogeneous and heterogeneous. And heterogeneous are the further two types: brazing, soldering. There is one more welding, gas welding. Let's track high energy. These are the homogeneous. And electric arc. These are the homogeneous beams which we are using. And electric arcs are further three types: MIG, TIG, and shielded metal arc sticks. So let's start about weldability of a metal. So metallurgically capacity. Parent metal will join with the weld metal without formation of deleterious constituents or alloys. So these are some weldability of a metal, how they are welded. Mechanical soundness. We are discussing mechanical soundness, like joint will be free from discontinuities, gas porosity and shrinkage, slag or cracks. Serviceability. Weld is able to perform under varying conditions or services, example extreme temperatures, corrosive environments, fatigue, high pressure. So extreme temperature, corrosive environments, if you are using welding, if you are doing, then there is some requirement that how we are doing welding, in which condition. Like if I want to do in extreme temperature, welding in extreme temperature and corrosive environments, fatigue, high pressure, then we can do. Fusion welding principles. There is some principles behind fusion welding. First, base metal is melted. Means base metal is melted. After welding, in welding, base metals are melting and ferrous metal may be added. Some filler metals which we are adding. And third is, heat is supplied by various means. Various means means we are using some fluid for heating, like oxyacetylene gas, electric arc, plasma arc, lasers. These are the some ways for generating heat and supplied. Heat supplied by various means. This is. And fusion welding. This is the diagram of fusion welding. So these are the parts of equipment, like electric coating, which is required, electrode coating and core wires inside is. And the base metal, weld, soldering slag and penetration depth. So this is some requirement of fusion welding, and this is the diagram what is happening behind that. And weld metal protection. How we are protecting our weld metal? Like during fusion welding, the molten metal in the weld puddle is susceptible to oxidation. And second is, must protect weld paddle, arc pole, from the atmosphere. we are protecting our weld metal from the atmosphere, and some methods which we are using, weld plates which we are using for protecting in atmosphere and gases, inert gases, helium neon which we are using for protecting, and vacuum. If you are doing welding in vacuum, then it is protected our metal. And weld fluxes which we are using, topical fluxes, SiO2, TiO2, FeO, MgO, L2O3. So this is the metal and the compound which we are using in our flux. And this is a gasket shield to prevent contamination. Act as a step to reduce oxides. Add alloying element to the weld. They are adding alloying element to the weld. Influence shape of weld bit during solidification. And inert gas which we are using, like argon, helium, nitrogen and carbon dioxide, for inert gases which we are using in welding for protecting from our metal from atmosphere and the gases. Form a protective envelope around the weld area. This forms the some area for protecting our weld. Used in MIG, TIG, steel metal arc, where we are using inert gases. And the vacuum. This is high quality welds. It produces high quality of weld. Used in electron beam welding. It is using in electron beam welding. And the third is nuclear special in nucleus special metal applications like ZR, UHF, TI, titanium, where we are using reduces impurities by factor of 20 versus other methods. So it is very important, and reduces the impurities by a factor of 20 versus other methods. So it is expensive and time consuming, but it is useful. Type of fusion welding. So oxyacetylene cutting AR welding, and the second shielded metal arc, and the metal inert gas MIG, and tungsten inert gas TIG, and oxyacetylene welding. Flame formed by burning a mix of acetylene and oxygen. In this welding, we are using acetylene and oxygen for burning. Comes out like a flame, and the fusion of metal is achieved by passing the inner core of the flame over the metal. Fusion of metal is achieved by passing the inner core of the flame over the metal, and the acetylene can also be used for cutting metals. After in welding times, when we are using oxyacetylene welding, then it's also melted our the base metal which we are using. So it's also using for cutting purpose. And shielded metal arc stick. An electric arc is generated between a coated electrode and the parent metal. And the second is coated electrode carries the electric current to form the arc. We are using coated electrode carries the electric current to form the arc. Produces a gas to control the atmosphere and provides filler metal for the weld bed. And the third, electric current may be AC or DC. You can use any current, AC or DC, which you want. If the current is DC, the polarity will affect the weld size and application. Electric current may be AC or DC. If the current is DC, the polarity will affect the weld size. So if you are using AC or DC, in DC, the polarity will affect the weld size and the application. And in shielded metal arc process, intense heat at the arc metal, the tip of the electrode. Intense heat at the arc melted melts the tip of the electrode, and the second, tiny drops of metal enter the arc stream and are deposited on the parent metals. And they are deposited on the parent metals. We are melting our electrode by the use of electricity. As molten metal is deposited, a slag form over the bed, which serves as an insulation against air contaminant during cooling. If you are using this, so we can also protect it our melt sorry metal from the atmosphere and the airs. After a weld pass is allowed to cool, the oxide layer is removed by a chipping hammer. So after welding by shell metal arc, after cooling, there is some gases which is cover our welding, and we can remove this scratches by hammering them. Inert gas welding for materials such as aluminium and titanium, which quickly form oxide layers. Aluminium and titanium, which are the metals, they are formed oxide layers, like a scratch which we are removing in shielding method. A method to place an inert atmosphere around the weld puddle had to be developed. And metal inert gas, MIG. This is the figure of metal inert, MIG, inert gas, which we are using. These are the parts of equipment, consumable electrodes, which are using drill wheels, power source, and arc column. And use a consumable electrode filler wire made of the base metal. And inert gas is typically argon. In inert gas, which are using like helium and argon, but there we are using always argon. And tungsten inert gas, MIG. Tungsten electrode act as a cathode. Here in this diagram, tungsten metal electrode act as a cathode, and a plasma is produced between the tungsten cathode and the base metal, which hits the base metal to its melting point. Ferrous metal can be added to the weld pool. In this diagram, this is some parts of like we are supplying power supply, and this is the arc column and paddle base metal. And in the next, welding positions. There is some welding positions, like we want to join two welding parts. Two metals to flat shape, horizontal shape, vertical, and the overhead. It's like a clap. And the weld defects. There is some defects which are generate after the welding, like undercuts, overlaps. This diagram shows the undercut and the overlap. And the grain growth. A wide delta T will exist between base metal and HAZ. Preheating and cooling method will affect the brittleness of the metal in this region. If you are welding, there is one more defect like grain growth. There is we are increasing the grain, number of grains. Because of that, the metal are so strength of metal is increasing. So this is also the defect. And the blowholes are cavities caused by the gas entrapped during the solidification of the weld pedal. After doing welding, when we are solidification, there is some gases which are entrapped inside the metal. They are forming the cavities and prevented by proper weld technique, even temperature and speed. So this is the defects. And inclusion is also the weld defect. like impurities or foreign substances which are forced into the weld pedal during the welding process have the same effect as a crack, prevented by proper technique and cleanliness, which is very important symptom. And the next is segregation. In segregation condition, where some regions of the metal are enriched within an alloy, ingredient and other area are not, can be prevented by proper heat treatment and cooling. And the third one is porosity. Porosity is also a weld defect, and the in porosity, the formation of tiny pinholes generated by atmosphere contamination prevented by keeping a protective shield over the molten weld puddle. It's like by generating temperature difference between them. And residual stresses. In welding, residual stresses, rapid heating and cooling result in thermal stresses determinant to joint strength. How we can prevent there is first is edge preparation, edge and alignment, bevel edge and space, we can use this. And control of heat input, skip or intermittent weld technique if you are using, then in control of heat input. And the preheating, reduce expansion or contraction forces alloys and removes moisture from the surface. If you are using this, then this type of stresses are not comes. And pinning, help metal stretch as it cool by hitting with a hammer. Use it here since it may work harden the metal. And the heat treatment, so the metal at a high temperature to relieve stresses. And the jigs and fixers, prevented distortion by holding metal fixed. Number of passes, the fewer the better. If you are just carrying, then this type of residual stresses are not comes in your way in joining. There are some joining designings which we are using for protecting joining purpose, like butt joint, this step joint, this it's like a rivet joint which we are using, but it's something different. And the fillet joint, it's like a T shape. And the lap joint, it's like our clap. If you are when we are clapping, it's like shape. And the corner joint, we are joining corners, this. And generalized welding symbols, some generalized welding symbols, like some details, far side details, electrode materials and weld geometry, these things. Examples of welding symbols. First, this geometry symbol for V group. This. And in this diagram, in this, one-sided welds are maximum 80% efficient to side, or 100% efficient. For a better joining, we are using shapes like that, V groups. And weld symbols, butt joints. This. In butt joints, there is some symbols which we are using, like square groups, and the second is this backing. We are using big groups, and fourth is bevel groups. Weld symbol fillet for fillet joints. First is it's like J groups. Circle we are cut, and the hair bevel groups, and the third one is bevel groups. The difference only this here is single straight line, and here is curved shape. Here we are removing a circle from the our material, and for corner joint from there.